Do you see the big boy out there?
In the back?
Yeah, that's him, right? He's just coming out right now.
My name is Denny Salisbury, Corporal, United States Marine Corps, retired.
He's mine.
When he turns broadside, he's clear. Go ahead and take him.
Thank you for joining us on this episode of Outdoor Channel's Grateful Nation with Double Diamond Outfitters.
Big buck coming in.
Yeah, that's a good deer.
Well, this particular hunt, we have a young man, a corporal, Denny Salisbury. He's brand new to hunting.
When he turns broadside, just right on his front leg, right on his shoulder, he's turning. As soon as you're comfortable, okay, go ahead and take him.
Servicemen and women pay the price to preserve our freedom. Join us as we reconnect wounded warriors with their roots as American sportsmen. And show our thanks as a grateful nation.
Y'all see all those sheep out there to the left?
Yeah. See them?
Yeah, there's some good sheep out there.
Now, Wes, what are we looking at? We're looking at the size of the horns, the body. What are we looking at?
They've got some really cool horns. So you're looking for the mass on them, and you're looking for the length of the horn.
Right. It's always fun to be the catalyst for somebody's new adventures in life. And on this particular hunt, we have a young man, a corporal, Denny Salisbury, United States Marine Corps, retired. And he's brand new to hunting.
The one that's on the left, standing broadside.
That's a great sheep.
See him, he's right there on the far right.
Yep, he's got his head down. He's kind of walking to the right a little bit.
My name is Denny Salisbury, Corporal, United States Marine Corps, retired. On April 16th, 2007, my truck was hit by an IED in Iraq, killing my platoon commander and my driver, and severely wounding myself and two others in the truck. It's been a long, long road to recovery, but since then I've found many outdoor experiences to take my mind off it, including cycling, mountain climbing, and now hunting.
Okay, we're at 185 right there.
He's walking towards the road. He's going up to the tree line. If he stops, take him. That's a great sheep. That's
please
a
stop.
Great
stop.
Sheep.
I hope he's running. Stop, bud.
Nope, he kept going. He's up in the wood. Okay, they're all moving now.
Yeah, I think that ewes just kind of got them stirred up.
They're all moving
and
out.
They're all following her. Yep.
Do you think we can follow them around to the backside? Yeah,
why don't we just try and circle back around? We'll see if we can get ahead of them. They'll probably keep following her wherever she goes,
right.
And we'll just go from there.
So after I was wounded, of course, it was an extensive recovery, and addiction was a part of that, and going into programs to get help was a huge part of that. Being in the outdoors has been one of the main reasons why I'm getting back to where I am as a person. You know, being outside is a way for me to be in contact with nature, be able to see the beauty that is everywhere around us.
That was a phenomenal
big
sheep.
Boy.
So we'll move up and see if we can't get around.
Yeah, we'll just circle back around in front of him. Let's sneak out of here. Go back this way.
I just found out today that his very first hunt, which was a few months back, was with Banded Brigade, which is run by one of our alumni from Grateful Nation, Bryce Cole.
After an outstanding all-dad hunt in New Mexico with Bryce Cole, he went on to join the Banded Brigade board and pay it forward by helping other injured vets discover the healing power of the great outdoors.
We're going to get by that rock right there. Okay, get by that rock. Get down.
You know, me and Steve kind of worked our way down to close that gap about as far as we could undercover. And we realized then that we had about maybe another 20 yards to go before we could get up on a ledge where we could see them and they could see us, and it was going to be game on.
Oh yeah, I got him. Is this better?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, this is way better.
You see him down there in those trees down there?
Okay, I got him.
Yeah. They're not going to jump out there real hard and fast or nothing. I don't know who's going to come first, but somebody will.
We really didn't see him that well in the beginning. They were kind of moved in behind this old cedar brush. So it worked out to our advantage, and laid the packs down. I got down real comfortable, and Steve just kept eyes on them the whole time with his binoculars, and we just waited.
The next one's a little one. This is a little one.
That's you.
It's a little one. Here comes the big one. The big one's coming up.
I see him.
Here comes the big one. All right, you ready?
All right.
Take him. Bryce, take him.
All right, I'm
take,
going. Are you ready?
Take, he's ready. He's done right there. He,
all right, all right.
Woo. Very right. Good.
All right.
Coming out here and seeing how Bryce Cole brought Corporal Denny Salisbury to us, I'm hoping that Denny Salisbury will do the same and go out and find other Marines, perhaps, other wounded soldiers out there somewhere, and bring them into the fold of this world that I like to call the Cathedral of the Outdoors.
You see him? You see that? You see him easing through the brush right there?
I see him.
I think they're coming up. There's a road or a sendero up here. Looks like they're easing towards the edge of that road. If we can get up there, they're probably gonna cross that road. We might get a shot.
Okay.
Let's ease up there real fast.
Okay.
See if we can get up there. They were kind of giving us a slip for a little bit, and so we had to work a little bit to get up on these red sheep and make sure we got the right one. We could have shot any red sheep, but we passed. Man, the guy put his life on the line to allow me to do what I love for a living. So I want him to get the biggest and the best that I got.
There they are, right there. Right there.
Do you see the big boy out there?
In the back?
Yeah, that's him right. He's just coming out right now.
Oh, he's a nice one. Hang on. All right, you're 120. 120.
Watching these sheep be, you know, acrobatic and prance around and jump, it was beautiful. This is nature at its finest.
Yeah, he's just stepping out. He's the one that just looked at us. He's the second one from the left there.
I see him.
Yeah.
He's mine.
When he turns broadside, he's clear. When he turns broadside, go ahead and take him.
Grateful Nation, presented by Federal Premium Ammunition, is brought to you by Federal Premium Ammunition. Every shot counts. Powered by Ram Trucks. Guts. Glory. Ram. Bushnell. Savage Arms. No nonsense. All performance. Champion. Shoot better. Have fun. And by Blackhawk. Honor as a way of life. See the big boy out there?
In the back?
Yeah, that's him right. He's just coming out right now.
We found a small little herd of sheep, and what a cool looking animal. This Iranian red sheep is just the coolest looking sheep. It has these big curls, and also has like this saddle right in the middle of the back. Looks like a saddle.
I've got my sights on him, but I also got this one in the back that's by himself.
Oh, he's a nice one.
Yeah, he's just stepping out. He's the one that just looked at us. He's the second one from the left there.
I see him.
Yeah.
He's mine.
When he turns broadside, he's clear. Go ahead and take him.
Got him. Nope.
He's heading back in.
Now he's about to walk into the bushes.
With the amount of sheep that we were seeing and the confusion I had with them, they all looked exactly the same. I kind of really didn't understand until I realized that it really was a big animal, and it had this big set of horns that were different from the other ones that we had glassed earlier in the day.
I think I see his head.
Yeah.
Is that him about to come out?
Yeah, he's coming out right now. Yeah, that's him on the right.
Yeah.
And you got a U in front of him, yeah.
A U?
Yeah. He needs to get clear.
Got him?
Got him.
Okay. Shoot him. Good shot. You got him. Good shot. He's going into the brush where...
He's moving. Yep, there he goes.
Yep, he's hit good.
At 140 yards, Corporal Salisbury made an outstanding shot. A sheep.
Heck yeah.
Not many people get sheep. Yeah.
That's good stuff.
Started your big game career.
So it begins.
That word thankful is not enough for me to describe the feelings I got out of this hunt. It's awesome. I'm going to take this home to my entire family, not just the meat. I'm going to take an experience home to where I'll be able to, you know, hopefully take a new hunter out, teach my daughter in the future how to hunt. It's something I'm really looking forward to.
Oh man, look at that girl.
You're a beauty.
Man, what a cool animal. Look at that. Now, Wes, is this some good master on these bases?
Yeah, that's a great sheep.
That's a nice curl too, huh? Look at that.
Yeah, he's...
Oh, wow. You can definitely see how big he is.
Great mass and really good length. You know, this time of year, they got a nice big tuft of black on them.
Not quite as big as the Aldab, but that's man.
Yeah, they got a big white saddle patch. I mean, he's going to make a beautiful mount. Yeah, a buddy of mine with the Texas Taxidermy Association, he said he'd be happy to mount this sheep for you. He said he'd mount anything that you shot. And
what? That's awesome.
He'd like to thank you for your service, much like we all would. And I'm going to take him back home with me, and James Porner's going to mount him for you.
To come home and have such hospitable people that are willing to put aside their living to help me to recuperate, you know, that right there, that is self-sacrifice. That is exactly what the military represents, is self-sacrifice. So for a civilian or even another military member or whoever you are, to go out of your way to help a veteran, that right there is equal to the sacrifice I gave.
Thanks for the opportunity,
yes,
man.
Sir. Thanks for coming out. That's appreciate it.
Oh, man. My pleasure.
Dude,
thanks for
blast.
Your service.
Wes Mundy is the owner here at Double Diamond Ranch, outside of San Antonio. So, you know he's an active supporter of our troops, donating his time and incredible resources to help our veterans get better. And that's just what he did 2 years ago when he took Corporal Jason Sellers on the hunt of a lifetime for Free Range All Dad in Alpine, Texas.
Wes Mundy. It's good to see you, buddy.
Man, it's great to be back.
It was two years ago.
Yeah.
Last time was in West Texas, outside of Alpine.
Yeah.
Hitting All Dad.
Yeah.
How awesome was that?
That was a blast. I love hunting, period, but I'm a sheep nut.
Right over on that brown patch, on that far hill, there's about 10 good All Dad. There's a pretty nice ram over there. It's going to be a little bit of a hike. This is not going to be easy. Lace your boots up.
Got up there and spotted what we finally, you know, thought was pretty nice, mature adult ram.
That's a perfect spot. There's a nice big rock ledge. I mean, it's a chip shot, 100 yards.
Are you serious?
But he's around the corner.
He's around the corner.
So we're going to have to try and get out here. There's a little point out here. That's a little further, sticks out a little further.
Did you see his little comrades?
No,
they might spot us or anything.
I didn't see anybody else. Just get down to this point and then go from there.
And we went up the draws and we went up around and we came in from the top and hiked in and hiked down to a pretty good distance away. Because we didn't want them to be spooked out of that hole, where they were hiding in the cave hole there.
So just stay on me. We'll load when we get up there. Right where that rock face goes vertical, he's right there. From this point, it's gonna be real. We gotta stay low, because he's
tough too.
We're
400 yards?
Yeah, I think so. It's not gonna be a real close shot, but that's as close as we've got right now. So stay behind me.
Ready and stay right,
yeah.
Right next to you.
Don't load anything yet, stay right behind me. And we're probably gonna have to crawl the last 15 yards or so.
No worries.
So just stay on me. We'll load when we get up there.
Yeah, yeah. This big old head up there.
Just get comfortable. I'm good, so don't worry about me.
Get in that nice shoulder position.
Good job.
Yeah, yeah. Buddy. Woo-hoo. He's down.
On all these hunts, I do what I can to donate my time and efforts and anything that I can do to help these guys out, I'm more than willing to help. Everybody that I know in this country gets to do exactly what they're doing because someone put their life on the line. So this is just a small way for me to say thank you to those guys.
Beautiful, Aw Dad. I can't thank you enough for coming with me.
I thank you guys enough.
It's not always easy to overcome these obstacles that we face, but I mean, if you're a veteran out there, I highly suggest to you to please don't, get yourself so down that you're doing all these other things that's not progressive in your lifestyle. Just try to find what works for you, but come out here to the great outdoors.
And that's exactly where Corporal Danny Salisbury is. And after taking a red sheep in the morning, he's ready for some more outdoor therapy in the form of a Texas whitetail.
Got that really awesome red sheep this morning. That was really beautiful. And now you said we can come out here and we're gonna do a little whitetail hunting?
Yeah, we've got some nice deer. We may see a bunch, we may not see anything. Right. You know, just hunting's hunting.
You having fun?
I'm having so much fun, I can hardly contain myself.
Hunting to me is, it represents everything I love to do. I love to be outdoors, I love to shoot my weapons, and I love to kind of sneak up on things, and I also love to eat meat. So that kind of checks all those boxes as a man. And to hunt, it's a new hobby that I'm gonna get deeply involved with.
We're getting close to the edge of that field. We're just gonna ease up around the corner, and then we'll hunker down in the brush. See, there's Balk, that young deer. Yeah.
I see him.
Yeah, he's looks like he's a little 4-point. He's a little bit young yet. Not a very big deer. We'll just let him, give him a couple more years. We've got some does coming out as well.
Oh yeah, I see him from the left over here.
Yeah, they're coming in from the left. Oh wow, check out all those turkeys that just came at us.
Oh my God.
20 of them out there.
They just keep coming.
That'll be a pretty good evening. The moon should be right. We've already got a bunch of deer coming in. We'll just be patient. Maybe something nice will come in.
We noticed that a group of does and a younger buck had showed up, but Wes led me on to believe that it was a better decision to wait. So we just waited.
Big buck coming in.
I see him. He's right there. Yeah, that's a good deer.
I take him.
Just put it right on his shoulder.
Grateful Nation, presented by Federal Premium Ammunition, is brought to you by Federal Premium Ammunition. Every shot counts. Powered by Ram Trucks. Guts, glory, Ram. Bushnell. Savage Arms, no nonsense, all performance. And by the Congressional Sportsman's Foundation. No legislation should come between you and the outdoors. Visit www.sportsmanslink.org to learn more.
Big buck coming in.
I see him, he's right there. Yeah, that's a good deer.
I take him.
We just waited and all of a sudden, this beautiful buck just walks out, and that was a pure opportunity for me to, take my first buck.
All right, Denny, he's 140 yards.
All right, I see him.
Just put it right on his shoulder.
All right.
When he turns broadside, just right on his front leg, right on his shoulder.
Okay, he's getting there.
Yeah, he's turning. As soon as you're comfortable.
All right, I'm ready.
Okay, go ahead and take him. Good shot, man. You got him. That's
nice.
Awesome. That's a heck of a deer, man.
That's a good deal.
Great shot.
Bam, I hit this buck and it's my very first buck. hit it, you know, one shot right in the shoulder, knocked him down, and it was beautiful.
That's a nice little deer.
Yeah, it looked like a 12 point to me.
He looked good.
He's a heck of a deer. I mean, especially for this part of Texas, he's a real nice deer. He gets to go home with a great whitetail and a great red sheep, and I couldn't be happier for him. He gets to go home with two great trophies. To me, it's a hunt I'll never forget, and I hope for him it's a hunt of a lifetime. Like I said, it's just a small token of my appreciation, and I can't thank him enough for coming down and hunting with me.
That's a good-looking deer, man. It's a really good-looking deer.
Now you got some venison for the freezer.
I know, right?
You never know whose life you're touching. You know, Denny Salisbury might go out there now and become a conduit to which 20 other veterans are touched by the world of hunting because he takes them out there, or he gets involved with Band of Brigade with Bryce Cole, or he just creates his own little slice of heaven for veterans to come on fishing trips and hunting trips. And that's what I'm hoping, is that, you know, you pay it forward. That's a beautiful deer.
Oh, man.
Super nice.
Man.
Look, an excellent shot.
That's an excellent shot.
That's right in the shoulder, right where we wanted.
I'm being thanked for on all these occasions through Ride Recovery, through No Barriers, through Grateful Nation, you know. These are thanks to me, but I don't feel that I deserve them, and I want to continue to give more. You know, a thanks isn't what I want. I want to change lives. I want to help people overcome their own difficulties, just like I continue to.
Federal Ammo did the job on him.
Sure
he
did.
He made a good shot, and you've got you a heck of a red sheep and then a heck of a first buck. That's a pretty good way to start your big game career.
Damn, right?
What do you think, Marine?
I'm amped. This is amazing. I'm definitely thankful again for this hunt. Double Diamond Outfitters, Grateful Nation, Federal Ammunition. You know, I wouldn't have been able to take those deer down without it. You know, I'm just thankful that this gear is, it's gonna help me to hunt in the future. So I'm very grateful for that.
It's got some good meat for the freezer and beautiful trophy, and can't thank you enough for your service, and can't thank you enough for coming down and hunting with me.
Man, thank you. Really, thank you. It's been a blast.